Does it get any better than this? Please. No! It doesn't get any better than this. Sitting there, I was doing a presentation years ago, and I looked out the window and I saw that, and I took a photo. And I thought, gee whiz, you know, doesn't that say it all? The sun is shining, there's that international icon, and it's the Sydney Harbour, and of course, it's the great Sydney jewel in Australia's crown of real estate. I wonder if prices are high. So, let's quickly go through what I've spoken about generally, and that's firstly the big picture for housing markets. And of course, the big picture certainly are interest rates. We've already talked about some nonsense this week in terms of interest rates. And that's, of course, of interest to all of us, because as soon as we hear the word higher interest rates, of course, it means some negativity in terms of our property market outcomes. And of course, interest rates are the biggest of the big picture. So interest rates clearly generate house price rise. There's no secret to why house prices rise and fall. There is no committee out there secretly determining where prices are going to go this week. You've got to understand what I'm saying. It's all about the cost of money. So even though interest rates determine the direction of our house prices, local factors determine the speed of the growth. All right? But interest rates are very, very important for the direction of our housing market. So let's have a quick look at the interest rate cycle that we've seen in recent years. Of course, it's been that roller coaster ride. In fact, we've seen that sort of a pattern with mortgage rates for the last 40 years. Right? Up and down, of course. Interest rates up, prices down. Interest rates down, prices up, etc., etc. So we've seen this remarkable flattening of interest rates over the last 4 years. Into the mining boom, we needed to stimulate our economy. So the Reserve Bank dropped interest rates, down came mortgage rates. But we can see some bumpy rides there in terms of the capital city market outcomes. Now we can see that underlying energy is similar, but the outcomes are different because of those local factors, the speed determining the speed. So you can see the city market's orange, up and running, fantastic, hyperdrive over the last 4 years. But we can see some bumps again along the way, but of course they were determined by, not the Reserve Bank, but by, well, not directly the Reserve Bank, but by the financial regulator, APRA, who came in and said, oh, we've got too many investors in the marketplace. Okay, so we want less fewer investors because in case interest rates rise, this could be a negative. Well, no history to back it up. No other modelling other than that some, you know, fanciful experimental policy called macroprudential policy. So, of course, we saw Sydney the favoured destination for